Tonight, the man who started a fire at a Duluth synagogue is in custody once again. Now it's up to the courts to decide what comes next.
Plus, results are in from Tuesday's election night, and we're learning more about some incomplete ballots by Duluth voters.
But first, emergency responders in northeastern Minnesota are looking for help updating a building. We're taking a look at some of the issues at their facility.
From CBS 3 Duluth, this is the CBS 3 News at 10.
Good evening, I'm Kristen Bakke.
And I'm Anthony Matt, thanks for joining us. EMTs in northern Minnesota are asking for your help. The Ely Area Ambulance Service is a nonprofit organization, and they're experiencing major problems with their aging facility.
Right now, their main concern is that the nearly half-century-old building is limiting their ability to respond to those experiencing an emergency. CBS 3's John Cardinelli traveled to the facility and shows us what the EMTs are dealing with.
This tin garage is home to the Ely Area Ambulance Service. It was built in the 1970s, and it's a mess.
My office leaks due to a floor drain freezing annually when it gets really cold. And we have leaking roof at times and foundation issues.
Jeffrey Golaski, the executive director of the service, and his 24-member staff are the only ambulance service in the Ely area. They cover more than 1,500 square miles, so they're concerned about response times. Making it more of a challenge, they have to rent a home for on-duty staff 6 blocks from the garage.
Being, 6 blocks away from the building here increases the response time, especially in the wintertime, so it adds, a few minutes of lag time, and sometimes that could be the difference between life and death.
The nonprofit only gets about $27,000 a year from tax funding, and grants are hard to come by. So now they're turning to the community to help build a new facility.
We're trying to get awareness out there and raise money from donations as we, in conjunction, seek grants.
The new facility will cost roughly $900,000. It will feature a larger garage with more space, a training facility, and a big perk that will help response times.
Also, we'll have live-in facility with kitchen, bedrooms, living room for the crew. So our response time is going to be like a full-time fire department. We can be out the door in under a minute, hopefully.
A quicker response, saving lives in the community they serve.
They only started fundraising recently, and so far they've raised $2,000. If you'd like to donate, you can find more information on our website, cbs3duluth.com.
The man convicted of burning down a Duluth synagogue is back in police custody tonight after violating probation orders for a second time. Police arrested Matthew Amiot on a warrant Tuesday night. Amiot, who is homeless, first violated terms of his probation several days after admitting he started the September fire at a Das Israel congregation. Then he failed to show up at the Chum Shelter in Duluth, followed by a meeting with his probation officer. On Monday, as part of his probation, he reported to Bethel, an inpatient treatment facility in Duluth, but after doing so, walked away.
St. Louis County court officials say the county is making a concerted effort to provide treatment as opposed to time behind bars. That's why Amiot was ordered to an inpatient facility once a bed opened up, rather than finishing his 90-day sentence. Assistant County Attorney Vicki Wanta says the end goal of probation, is rehabilitation.
The courts are usually going to want to try to get a defendant into treatment to hopefully fix these long-term, deep-rooted issues, hoping for more long-term effects.
What happens next is a conversation between Amiot's probation officer and the court to decide what comes next.
A 22-year veteran of the Duluth Police Department is on leave tonight after being arrested for allegedly drunk driving. Officer Daryl Diver is charged with DUI and refusing a breath test last week. According to court documents, police pulled over the 48-year-old on Monday, October 28th. The traffic stop happened near North 9th Avenue East and Central Entrance after watching him hit several curbs and almost another car. That officer called the Minnesota State Patrol. Diver told the state trooper he had 7 or 8 drinks that night. Authorities say Diver was slurring his words and stumbled when he got out of his car. He was arrested and refused a breath test. Duluth police say an internal investigation is underway. Diver is due in court next month. Meanwhile, police would not say whether Diver is on paid or unpaid leave.
New at 10, a federal jury indicted a Maple, Wisconsin man for robbery and gun crimes. Patrick Staton was charged for robbing a gas station in Brule, Wisconsin. The 29-year-old's charges also include being a felon in possession of firearms and ammunition. The U.S. Attorney's Office says the robbery took place in late August. If Staton is convicted, he faces a maximum sentence of 20 years for the robbery charges. In addition, he could face a maximum of 10 years on the firearm and ammunition charges.
Let's head over to Dave for a quick look at weather. Dave, there were some snowflakes in Duluth this morning. Not too many, but it seemed like there was quite a bit up near Ely.
Yeah, the Canadian border and the UP had the best snow chance today, and it paid off for them. And a little bit around the rest of the region as well. Still a chance for some flurries tonight as that low pressure system to our south and east tracks away. Higher pressure is building in to clear things up tomorrow. So that's why in between we've got the chance for a little more precip coming our way. Day planner for Thursday says a chilly start once again. Record low temp tied in Hibbing this morning at 5 above. I think we'll be around 10, 12 tomorrow morning. Only about 25 in the afternoon with a partly cloudy sky from another charging high-pressure system that'll keep things on the cool side for a couple of days. The whole weekend, too? Well, we'll let you know with a 7-day forecast in just a few more minutes.
Thanks, Dave. More than 21,000 Duluthians voted in yesterday's election, but what might be more interesting is how many of those people didn't fill out the entire ballot. For example, in the at-large city council race, voters were asked to vote for two candidates to fill two seats. But about 7,500 people, or about a third of everyone who cast a ballot, only voted for one or didn't vote for anyone. It's a process called undervoting, and it's something we also saw in yesterday's school board at-large race. Experts say undervoting is something candidates can try to use to their advantage. Instead of only campaigning for voters' support on election day, they also ask voters to forego their right to choose another candidate in the same race. The goal is to further the distance between themselves and the next closest candidate. While the numbers wouldn't have played a role in the mayoral race, they could have played a role in what was one of the more watched races. That's the at-large city council race. You can see only about 250 votes separated incumbent Noah Hobbs from the second place vote getter, Eric Forsman. So those 7,500 undervotes could have played a big role depending on which candidate they went to. In the at-large race for the school board, nearly all of the undervotes would have had to go to Alana Oswald's challenger to make a difference.
Sticking with that election, a first for Duluth politics after voters elected Janet Kennedy to the Duluth City Council Tuesday night. Kennedy becomes the first African American to serve on the council, serving West Duluth. She defeated Jeannie Kinesny with 51% of the vote. Kennedy says she'll focus on housing, transportation, and economic development. President of the Duluth NAACP, Stefan Witherspoon, weighed in today on Kennedy's win.
All the conversations that we have as a community, all the things that we fight for, all the things that we bring awareness to, she will bring that to the table and she will talk about it. And we want to see some tangible change and that it's fair and equitable across the board.
Kennedy takes over for the seat held by longtime city councilor Jay Fosley, who did not seek re-election. Lobbying group Duluth BizPAC issued a statement congratulating the winners of last night's election. The group says it looks forward to working with elected officials to change the image and culture of Duluth to make the city more business-friendly. They also said they hope our elected officials want to help Duluth grow. While the statement didn't directly mention Mayor Emily Larson's re-election, BizPAC has been critical of her in the past.
U.S. Senator Tina Smith is introducing a bill to make it easier for veterans to get care for hearing loss. The Democratic senator from Minnesota says hearing loss is one of the things she hears about the most from veterans. She says currently, to receive hearing aids and treatments for tinnitus, veterans must prove their hearing ailment is from their time in the military. Her bill aims to cut through that red tape.
Our core value is that if you have served our country, it is up to all of us to make sure that the health issues that you develop because of that service, we take care of. And that's really at the root of my bill.
The bill still needs a committee hearing before it can advance any further. Meanwhile, Wisconsin Senator Tammy Baldwin is working to secure additional funding aimed to restore the Great Lakes. The Great Lakes Restoration Initiative is a bipartisan plan to improve the quality of the Great Lakes Basin. Senator Baldwin wants to secure an extra $9 million to go towards that initiative. The funds are used for habitat restoration and preventing invasive species within the Great Lakes. Baldwin says that some of the funding will also go towards fighting lakeshore erosion.
One of the things that's really important to do with some of this Great Lakes Restoration Initiative funding is to make our shoreland more resilient from erosion.
Since 2010, the initiative has provided more than $2.5 billion to fund over 4,000 projects.
Public records show the Minnesota Department of Human Services violated state law more than 200 times over the past year.
Yeah, this comes after it awarded $52 million in contracts and grant commitments without proper documentation. Records obtained by the Star Tribune show employees sometimes allowed vendors and grantees to perform work without finalized contracts, while in other cases, employees bought products such as software without required permission. The newspaper reports the records taken together suggest a pattern of financial mismanagement.
Department officials say the agency has safeguards preventing money from going out the door in those situations.
Still to come on live, local CBS 3 workers at a Twin Cities YMCA save a woman's life. They say it's important for everyone to learn how to do the same.
High temp today, only 26 degrees. The normal is 41. I don't think we'll hit normal in the week ahead. How close will we get? I'll show you with the 7-day forecast right after our break.
Live, local, CBS 3 News at 10. With Kristen Vaki, Anthony Matt, Kelly Hinson, and weather with meteorologist Dave Anderson on Live, local, CBS 3.
We tip our hats to the men and women who serve to protect hearth and home. At Slumberland's Veterans 3-Day Sale this Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, get $25 off your purchase of $49 or more, or $100 off your purchase of $5.99 or more. Plus, veterans and active service members get an extra 10% off with our gratitude. Here's to those who keep us safe. Here's to our veterans. Slumberland Furniture.
Do you know what the U of M does for you? From farms to breweries and orchards to markets, discover how the University of Minnesota is cultivating a new crop of Minnesota businesses.
With the Honda Civic, fun and sporty can also be practical and efficient. That's because the Civic LX has more horsepower than the Toyota Corolla L, Nissan Sentra S, and Hyundai Elantra SE, and more passenger space than the Corolla L, Sentra S, and Elantra SE. With standard Honda Sensing, a suite of safety and driver-assisted features, it's the whole package in one stunning wrapper. And it's why you made the Civic the best-selling compact car in America. Visit your Lake Superior Honda dealer and test drive a Honda today.
The Dish voice remote just got even more powerful. Why'd we put so much technology in there?
You don't think I've watched a lot of football?
You want to put a little wager on it?
Bet.
So you can settle that bet without ever taking your eyes off the game.
How many D1 football teams are there?
What you do with that power?
Oh, it's gotta hurt.
Well, that is totally up to you.
Don't look so sad, man. Come on, we're having fun.
New Dish voice remote with the Google Assistant. Dish, tuned in to you.
Coop's Pizza is the family favorite choice for pizza, Italian food, and sandwiches. Dine in, pick up carside, take and bake, or order Coop's frozen pizza online and get the great taste and fresh ingredients delivered for you to enjoy whenever you want. Coop's Pizza, Hayward, Wisconsin.
Fall is in the air at Oak Lake RV, so all 2019 models must go. You waited for the best time of year to buy, and this is definitely it. We have a great selection of new and late model trades that are all marked down. Trades welcome, featuring great brands like Coachmen, Rockwood, Sierra, Palomino, and more. So stop in and tour our showroom today at Oak Lake RV in Moose Lake, family owned and operated since 1930.
Now, the CBS 3 Duluth WeatherMax forecast with meteorologist Dave Anderson.
The cold weather is here just in time for Winter Hazard Awareness Week. State government in Minnesota, Wisconsin, and National Weather Service banding together to remind us about things we need to know with the upcoming winter. Today's topic, fire safety. Yeah, the heating season is here, so be careful, especially with wood stoves. Get those chimneys clean. Tomorrow, it's carbon monoxide with people staying indoors and heating with wood and things like that. Make sure your CO detector is working. And come Friday, They'll refresh us on our winter driving skills. And with snow coming tonight for the UP and flurries for the rest of the region here, perhaps we need to brush up on our skills early. We'll talk about the snow chance and the cold chance and any hint of a warm-up in just a little bit. But right now, we take a look at how things are going current condition-wise at the airport in Duluth. Down to 17, relative humidity up to 59%, and the winds holding fairly steady at 14 miles per hour from the northwest. Air pressure is pretty high at 30.5 inches of mercury, or 1,034 millibars. And a new high is coming in overnight tonight that may bump that reading up to 1,040 millibars. The normal is 1,013. Current temp in Watersmeet, 18, 20 for Ironwood, 21 Ashland, down to 16 Hayward, down to 14 Solon Springs, only 17 in Superior, 18 for Moose Lake and Barnum, 16 Two Harbors, 13 Hibbing, 14 Grand Rapids, 17 International Falls. Well, what we're getting at here is it's going to be a cool one again tonight, cooler than normal. Arctic high pressure coming to call will make things down to about 10 or so for a lot of towns, especially away from the lake. This cold snap, frankly, will be with us for the week ahead. Best we'll get towards normal. Normal's around 40, 41. It's Saturday when we might hit 35 degrees, otherwise fairly brisk. Now, we're talking about snow chances from a leaving low-pressure system and sun chances with an entering high-pressure system. The best chance for snow tonight, again, will be for portions of the Upper Peninsula, mostly lake effect thanks to the fetch of the winds off of the lake. From the Keweenaw to the east, winter weather advisory. Some of this, though, may backtrack in towards places like Wakefield and Bessemer and Ironwood. And then we're still getting a couple of snow showers here and there around the rest of the region, so do drive cautiously. It's not horrible, but you know, when you let your guard down, that's when things come across that you don't like. Coming across, well, right now there's that low centered to our south, and here comes that reinforcing shot of high pressure that'll try to clear us up again for tomorrow, but keep us chilly for quite a while. Another snow chance coming our way? Yeah, I think come Saturday there's a chance for some light stuff, thanks to another low pressure system that's taking shape right now towards Billings. Forecast tonight in Minnesota, like we mentioned, a bit on the brisk side. Low temps will be anywhere from 10 to 15, 30% chance for the flurries we were talking about, 40% chance for the light snow showers in Wisconsin and Michigan, and again, the South Shore Snow Belt into the UP has the best chance for anything to stick, maybe an inch or so in that neck of the woods. For tomorrow, though, the higher pressure brings back the sun, partly cloudy Wisconsin, Michigan, highs near 25 if you're lucky. In Minnesota, 20 to 25 degrees inland, about 26 by the lake. Warmer by the lake by a degree, I guess that counts. Partly cloudy for Friday, for Thursday. Friday is a different story as that other low comes around, so it clouds up again, but it starts to warm up thanks to the cloud cover. Back to 30. Did you ever think, you know, we're only 2 months away from summer, we'd have to be saying we're excited for 30? Then 35 on Saturday with a chance for some snow showers for Minnesota deer opener. Come Veterans Day on Monday, though, then it really starts to get chilly. Overnight lows in the single digits by the lake. Some below zero spots are not out of the question during that same period.
All right, thanks, Dave. Well, a 73-year-old woman has some quick-thinking YMCA workers to thank for saving her life. She was taking a water aerobics class in a Twin Cities suburb when her heart stopped.
As Mary McGuire reports, that's when the class instructor and two lifeguards jumped into action.
On any given day, the water aerobics classes at the Southdale YMCA are packed. About 40 members were in the pool Monday afternoon, grooving to the music, when a 73-year-old woman suddenly slumped over in the water.
We did some kind of listening for breath and taking her pulse and seeing if
Natalie Martin was teaching the class.
The AED came after about one round of compressions and some rescue breathing, and thank goodness for that AED.
After using the device, the woman's heart started beating again.
And to know that we had a successful outcome and that she is breathing today and that I might get to see her again is emotionally overwhelming.
It is a lifesaver for sure.
Most of the YMCA staff has to go through CPR, oxygen, and AED training, so they are prepared for incidents like this.
We always talk about the unexpected, but this is what we're trained for and this is what we get ready for.
This woman, very fit, works out here all the time. We all know her.
A heart emergency can strike anyone at any time. It's important people stay in tune with their bodies and look out for these warning signs.
Any type of dizziness, excessive unexpected sweating, heart palpitations.
The staff at the YMCA says this is just the second time this year that the AED device has been used. The woman that was rescued from the pool is still recovering in the hospital. Still to come on Live Local CBS 3, we're learning there may have been more than 1,000 children separated from their families at the U.S.-Mexico border as the government makes new identifications. More on this after the break.
CBS 3 Live Cams are brought to you by Kohler Toyota. Presidential award-winning service. You're not just getting a car, you're getting Kohler. KohlerToyota.com.
Water makes life possible on Earth and in our homes. Culligan conserves this resource with its high-efficiency water softener. The world's best because it uses less water. And that matters to all of us. Click or call Culligan Water and start saving today.
Order new packing peanuts.
Why?
They're stale. I'm upgrading the toilet paper. It's soft, huh? Here are the new safety vests I ordered. Huh? What do you think?
What's he doing now?
Testing the hard hats.
Ooh. I'm okay.
Western National can cover your business and your home. With Western National, you'll have to find something else to worry about.
When looking for a TV and internet provider, we know you have a choice. This is Jessica. She still has satellite TV.
Well, I get tons of HD.
Spectrum has tons of HD. And we get exclusive access to premium original content with Spectrum Originals.
I don't have that. Plus, sometimes in the rain, our services go out.
Because of the dish on your roof?
Get Spectrum TV from $44.99 a month. Call 833-916-4499.
And Spectrum Internet starts at 100 megabits with no data caps and a free modem.
We have to get internet from another company, and it isn't nearly as fast.
Spectrum Internet, $44.99 a month.
I'd switch, but I'm stuck in a contract and would have to pay up to $480 to cancel.
Spectrum has no contracts, and they'll pay up to $500 to help you out of yours.
That's it. I'm switching to Spectrum.
Get Spectrum TV and internet from $44.99 a month each. Call 833-916-4499.
It's Truck Month in the Northland, where we take on every tough job, any rough terrain, and no matter what comes our way, we keep on trucking. Yeah, we're tougher up here. And there's only one brand of truck built to keep up. During Truck Month, get up to $9,250 cash back on a Ford F-150 or lease F-150 for just $299 a month. Only your local Northland Ford dealer.
Attend Lake Superior College's Business and Industry Career Night Thursday, November 21st, 4:30 to 7 p.m. Visit LSE's main campus to learn about programs in exciting in-demand career fields like accounting, auto body and auto service, business, carpentry, and more. Visit lsc.edu to RSVP today.
Nobody carries more Columbia than Northwest Outlet.
Duke is a man of few words and many songs.
Let freedom ring. Gone country.
I ain't going down till the sun comes up.
It's 102.5.
Duke.
Coast Guard teams are searching for an airman who disappeared after a training skydive. He exited an aircraft over the Gulf of Mexico Tuesday. Officials say he was wearing a parachute that did deploy, but crews lost sight of him after he hit the water off of Destin. Florida Fish and Wildlife teams and Air Force personnel are helping the Coast Guard with the search. That missing airman has not yet been identified.
In politics, the Trump administration separated more families along the U.S.-Mexico border than was previously disclosed. That's according to a court documents filed today. The government has identified more than 1,500 children who officials believe were separated from their parents at the border between July of 2017 and June of 2018. This adds to the more than 2,700 families who have been separated under the administration's controversial zero-tolerance immigration policy.
Kelly's here to talk a little bit about sports, some soccer.
Soccer, UMAC, soccer playoffs coming to an end here. Plus, Wolves finally get Cat back down in Memphis. Love highlights next.
We tip our hats to the men and women who serve to protect hearth and home. At Slumberland's Veterans 3-Day Sale, this Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, get $25 off your purchase of $49 or more, or $100 off your purchase of $5.99 or more. Plus, veterans and active service members get an extra 10% off with our gratitude. Here's to those who keep us safe. Here's to our veterans. Slumberland Furniture.
Dear Catwalk, my sleek curves and chiseled looks may make for some seriously striking poses, but a real supermodel is all about what's inside. That's why I bring sharp tech and advanced safety, which the paparazzi can't seem to get enough of. Oh, please, no photos. Mwah. Corolla.
Right now, you can get $1,000 customer cash on a stylish new 2020 Toyota Corolla. Find yours at buyatoyota.com. Toyota, let's go places.
Hey, Minnesota, don't miss Orange Friday at Fleet Farm, your one stop for the season opener. Doors open 6 a.m. Friday with incredible doorbusters and blazing hot deals. Find gear, ammo, snacks, and everything in between. You can even gas up your truck. Plus, earn bonus bucks on top of Orange Friday savings. Hurry in. The first 500 customers in the door get an exclusive Orange Friday collector's hat and stretch and win tickets. Fleet Farm. Built for real life.
We not only have
blasting business banter. Your top salesman is working from home while working to close a deal. But his Uncle Larry decided to stop by 2 weeks ago. This looks like a job for smile power. Good thing your employees have dental insurance backed nationally by over 65 years of molar defending experience. So their healthy deal closers are always ready to close. Unleash your smile power with Delta Dental. Delta Dental.
Power up your devices with Extreme Internet. With speeds from 100 meg up to 1 gig, you'll get the most out of your tech. Switch today and save 56%. Stunning streaming video, unbeatable gaming, incredible in-home Wi-Fi. Want even more? Ask about deals on TV service with TiVo and take your home entertainment to the extreme. Switch to Extreme Internet 100 today for $34.99 a month for 1 year. Call 844-EXTREME2.
My name is Dan Metcalf. I'm a general surgeon and a colorectal surgeon at Memorial Medical Center. I bring a new set of skills to Ashland, and some of what Ashland would allow me is a culture that is very patient-centered. That's a really important part of surgery or medicine in general, is really getting to know the people that you're taking care of. I get the joy of seeing patients every day and taking care of people every day and learning about their lives as well as fixing them.
CBS 3 Sports with Kelly Hinson.
As the seventh-ranked team in the United Coaches Regional Poll, it's no surprise that the UW Superior men's soccer team is in the top overall seed in this year's UMAC tournament. At home for the semifinals today against the five-seed Martin Luther. First half, the Jackets strike first in this one. Miguel Ocampo with a soft touch for Blake Perry. The keeper cannot hang on to it. It's 1-0 Jackets. A few minutes later, the speedy sophomore was at it again, sends a shot on net, and the second guy there, Blake Doye, nearly finishes it off, but the save is made. That defense would not last, though. Pontus Tavmark to Perry, and then back to Tavmark. 5 first half goals for Superior. The Jackets win it 6-0. They advance to take on St. Scholastica, who won 3-0 over Bethany Lutheran. It will be the 5th straight season that the Twin Ports rivals will face off for the conference championship. On the women's side, St. Scholastica is on to the championship game with a 2-0 win over Martin Luther, while the Yellow Jackets fell on the road to Northwestern. Karl Anthony Towns returned to the Timberwolves lineup as they took on the Grizzlies tonight in Memphis. Tyus Jones, but this time in a Grizzlies uniform. Jones sets up Brandon Clark with an alley-oop toss. Clark finishes with the huge dunk for the Grizzly lead, rather. Minnesota trying to claw back. Towns showing off his ball handling with the drive to the hoop, getting the bounce off the glass, but the score would remain in Memphis's favor. Wolves fall 137 to 121. Hey, Andrew Wiggins had 26 points on the night, though. Cat had 25. Let's move on to hockey. It is the weekend that the UMD Bulldog men's hockey team and fans have been looking forward to. NCHC league play starts this weekend, and the Bulldogs start their conference play out in likely the most difficult way possible. It'll be a battle of two nationally ranked teams, both in the top 10, no less, this weekend at Amsoil Arena. The number 7 ranked Bulldogs play host to the undefeated number 1 ranked Denver Pioneers. The last time the Bulldogs met the Pioneers, you may remember UMD handed them a 3-0 loss in the NCHC Frozen Faceoff down at the Xcel Energy Center in February. So you know that this is a team ready to come out swinging this Friday night.
Good, we're underdogs, finally, you know. They should be excited because we didn't play last weekend, and we're coming off two big wins, and it's amazing when different teams come in, the energy level goes up, so hopefully we can keep that through the week and into the weekend, and I just hope that that can carry over into the weekend because we're going to need to be at our best. They're playing right now, well right now, and they're riding an 8-game winning streak, and are probably feeling very, very confident in how they're playing, and they should because they're a good team.
You can watch both games this weekend as the Bulldogs welcome in the Pioneers for their first league game of the year. Puck drop is at 7:07 both Friday and Saturday on My9 Sports. I will be ringside and delivering intermission reports both evenings. And in some coaching news announced today, Wade Chiodo has officially been announced as the newest Grand Rapids hockey coach. Chiodo takes over for Chris Marianucci, who resigned last month. Chiodo was most recently the head boys coach at Bemidji High School, where he was named Class A Coach of the Year in 2015. He played for Bemidji State from 2001 to 2004. That's going to do it for sports tonight. We'll be right back after the break.
CBS 3 Closed Captioning is brought to you by Accenture Health St. Mary's Medical Center, proud to serve as the Northland's only adult Level 1 trauma center.
Alexa, turn on the house lights.
Now, during SUV season, get over 6,000 total savings or lease an Escape for just $249 a month, only at your Northland Ford dealers.
Real steel. Find yours. Right now, double your run times when you buy an AK or AP battery set and get the second battery half off. Battery power made by steel. Find yours at steeldealers.com.
Why do you need fast, reliable internet so your world doesn't turn upside down? Turn it around. Switch to Spectrum. And give your family what they deserve. Switch to Spectrum Internet for just $44.99 a month with free modem. Call 1-833-624-4499. With starting speeds of 100 megabits, you'll be able to connect your devices at the same time and with no data caps. Spectrum Internet has the fastest, most consistent download speeds based on the latest FCC report. AT&T can't say that. And with Spectrum TV, you get over 125 channels with free HD and free on demand. Plus, you get the free Spectrum TV app to stream your favorite shows and movies in and outside your home. Switch to Spectrum TV for just $44.99 a month. Call 1-833-624-4499. And no contract. Call and switch to Spectrum Internet and TV for just $44.99 a month each. Spectrum will even buy out your current contract up to $500. Call 1-833-624-4499. Turn your world around. Call now.
We build innovative trucks to serve the people who depend on them. Cabins to comfort. Power to do more. Now to say thank you, we're extending our Employee Pricing Plus to everyone. What's right for the people who build your trucks is right for you. Welcome to the Ram Nation.
Well-qualified returning FCA lessees can lease the 2019.
Bentleyville Tour of Lights begins their season on November 23rd.
Pretty cool night for all of those do-gooders out there tonight, huh?
Yeah, and it'll be chilly again tomorrow morning, just like it was this morning. High temps tomorrow, perhaps in the 20s, maybe mid-20s if we push it. But that's about as best as it's going to get. Sunshine, though, thanks to high pressure coming aboard. Low pressure starts to take over as early as Friday, though, so we start to go towards mostly cloudy. Then the warm day of the week, Saturday at 35. That's still 5 degrees cooler than normal, but that's the best we'll get.
Thanks, Dave. Thanks for joining us.
We'll see you tomorrow night.